Good morning, children. Welcome to your class of English. Let's start today's class. Children, when you wake up early in the morning and if you just step out of your house or if you just go on your terrace, if you look around, what you observe, children? Yes, beautiful morning day, beautiful morning with clear sky, with many birds flying in the sky, people walking around, okay? And if you just turn your head and look around, everywhere you find greenery, right? Many big trees, flowers, variety of trees, variety of flowers with different colors. So beautiful. Our nature is very beautiful with different things. Do you enjoy nature? Yes, we all love our nature and we really enjoy our nature. So our today's topic is about nature. Shall we start? Let's begin. Children, open your textbook, page number 10. Okay, it's a beautiful poem, A Beautiful Day. A Beautiful Day, written by William Wordsworth. The poem, A Beautiful Day, is written by William Wordsworth. Okay, he was a popular English writer. He has written many stories and poems in English. Okay, he was really a famous poet and writer. He has written many stories and poems in English. Like many poems written by him, A Beautiful Day is a poem about nature. See here, about nature. See what a beautiful view. See, open your textbook and just see what all you can observe here, children. Yes, see, beautiful grass, green grass, water is flowing here. See, cattle, see so many cattle grazing here, eating grass. Yes, clear blue sky. You can see small clouds here. And see cock here, cock crowing. Have you ever heard cock crowing? Coo-coo-coo-coo, right? Yes, see here birds. You can see birds flying in the sky. And many beautiful, see beautiful view. Birds here, see, birds sitting on next to their nest with their babies. Okay, see, this is what a beautiful nature is. Okay, so today we are going to learn this poem. Okay, first I will read, then I will explain you, children. Okay, a beautiful day. The cock is crowing, the stream is flowing. The small birds twitter, the lake doth glitter. The green field sleeps in the sun. The oldest and the youngest are at work with the strongest. The cattle are grazing, their heads never raising. There are 40 feeding like one. Okay, now, like an army defeated, the snow hath retreated. And now doth fare ill on the top of the bare hill. The ploughboy is whooping, anan, anan. There's joy in the mountains. There's life in the fountains. Small clouds are sailing. Blue sky is prevailing. The rain is over and gone. Okay, this is a poem. Now, let me explain you. This poem is all about nature. Okay, the poem is telling us about the beauty of season. The beauty of season. The winter season is over and now spring season has come. Okay, now here see, the cock is crowing, the stream is flowing, the small birds twitter, the lake doth glitter. The poet tries to tell us about different things that are in nature. See, the day begins with crowing of the cock. Okay, morning, you might have heard cock crowing, coo-coo-coo-coo. Okay, that is called crowing of cock. Cock's sound made by cock, which tells us that it is morning. Along with the rising of the day, the stream still continues to flow. Okay, the stream is flowing. So the stream still continues to flow. The birds twitter. Twitter means sound. They make sounds. Okay, sounds made by birds. The small birds twitter. The birds around have woken up too. And they are chirping around in the nature. See, they are chirping around in the nature. The lake doth glitter. Glitter means shining. Glitter means shining. The lake glitter means shines as the sun rises and shines brightly in the sky over the green field. See, the green field sleeps in the sun. Means the sun shines. Okay, the sun rises and shines brightly in the sky over the green field. Okay, now understood, children? Now, the oldest and the youngest are at work with the strongest. The cattle are grazing, their heads never raising. There are 40 feeding like one. Okay, now the old and young people have woken up too and have started their daily routine with lot of hard work and concentration. Strongest are at work with the strongest means they started their daily routine with lot of hard work and concentration. Children, what is your daily routine? Yes, getting up early in the morning and getting ready for school. That is your routine. And even your parents also, they get up early in the morning and they also get ready to go to their respective jobs, respective work. So the poet tries to show us a normal beginning of the day, how the day begins. Okay, it's just the normal beginning of the day. Now see, the cattle are grazing. Grazing means eating grass. Cattle, see, cows here, you can see cows here. How? See, they are grazing, means they are eating their morning food. The cattle are grazing, their heads never raising. Means the cattles are eating their morning food. Eating their morning food with lot of concentration that they are not raising their heads. They are so busy in eating that even they are not raising their heads. Okay. And see, when they are eating together, see here you observe, see your children. When you see this, there are so many cattles. When they are eating together, okay, when they are eating their food together, they are all looking like one cow is eating the food. Okay, so the cattle are grazing, their heads never raising. There are 40 feeding like one. Means when you see the cattle together eating the food, they look like one cow eating. Okay, understood, children? Yes. Now, like an army defeated, the snow hath retreated. The poet here tells us that the winter season is going away now and spring season has begun. The spring season has begun. It is as if the army of snow season is defeated. What is the meaning of defeated, children? Defeated means losing, lost. Okay, see, when you have some match, okay, two teams play. One will be the winner and another will be the loser. So losing is nothing but defeating. So like it is as if the army of snow season is defeated and the spring season has won the battle. Means, and now doth retreated. What is the snow hath retreated? Retreated means moving back. Okay, moving back. And doth fare ill. And doth fare ill means, what is the meaning of fare ill? Fare ill here means existing. Okay. So the spring season has won the battle on the top of the bare hill. Means the hills are bare. Bare means, what is the meaning of bare, children? Bare means nothing is there now. It is simple, plain, without any snow. All the snow has gone. Okay, all the snow has gone as the snow season is gone now. So there is no snow on the hill. And the hill doesn't have any snow on it. The hill is covered only with green grass and flowers. Green grass and flowers. Okay. Now, the plow boy is whooping. Anan, anan. There's joy in the mountains. There's life in the fountain. The plow boy is whooping. Means, the plow boy. What is the meaning of plow boy, children? Yes, it means boy who guides animal to draw a plow in the field. To draw a plow in the field. So the plow boy is whooping. What is the meaning of whooping? Whooping means shouting with excitement, with expressing with joy. Expressing with joy. Okay. He's trying to express that spring season has come. So he screams loudly. What he screams loudly? Anan, anan. Means the plow boy is so happy that he started screaming with excitement. Anan, anan. Okay. There's joy in the mountains. There's life in the fountains. Small clouds are sailing. Blue sky prevailing. The rain is over and gone. Means, if you observe, see here, if you observe the nature, the picture here, you feel as if the mountains and fountains are so happy and have come to life after the harsh winter days. Yes, children, winter days are very harsh, right? Always we have to wear sweaters, mufflers, cover our body with woolen clothes. So summer is very harsh on our body. So cold, right? Now, small clouds are sailing, blue sky prevailing. What is the meaning of prevailing, children? Prevailing means existing. So the sky is also clear now. The sky is clear now and blue with small clouds. See, small clouds as if they are floating smoothly in the air. Okay, the days of rough climate has gone. What is rough climate here? Winter. Yes, winter and rainy season is over and gone. Now it is a spring day. Now it is the which season? Spring season. Okay, so a beautiful poem, right? This is a beautiful poem. A beautiful day of changing season. What does this poem tell us, children? Yes, a beautiful day of changing season that tells us that there is a positive change in nature. Okay, so there is a positive change in nature. Hope you understood, children. Okay, read again and again. Now, see here, please underline here: crowing, flowing, twitter, glitter. See, rhyming words: crowing, flowing, twitter, glitter. Okay, these are called rhyming words. And the cattle are grazing. Underline grazing here. Their heads never raising. Underline raising here. Okay, now come to the next page. Underline defeated. underline hath retreated. Then come to next line, underline fair, then underline bear, underline plowboy, underline whooping, then underline fountains, then prevailing. So this is all about nature, a poem. Now these are the new words you have to write in your English classwork neatly. Okay children, hope you understood today's class. Please, if you have any doubt, call me and clarify your doubts. That's all for today's class. Take care. Bye-bye.